Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. So we get to see Russia's new VTOL aircraft for the next major update here. Just like with the Harrier for the United States and British tech trees, Russia gets a Yak-38 and Yak-38M, one standard and one premium. One of which is going, the premium is going to be a bundle pack just like with the US Harrier, but we haven't seen any of the actual announcements for those bundle packs. They just seem to be kind of, I guess they're going to wait until the update releases before they're made available, unlike the T-72, which is a pre-order pack. I guess that's fine to do that, but we already saw these. We already knew that Gaijin was going to be adding something for the Soviet Union when it comes to their VTOL aircraft, but when they showed off the new carriers, the new AI carriers, you could actually see Yak-38s in the screenshots, just like with the British, you could see a Buccaneer. So I don't know if we're getting that too with the next update or not, but these were already seen in in some screenshots previously to kind of tease, I guess. But let's go ahead and take a closer look. So the Yak-38 was a Soviet strike fighter with VTOL capabilities developed in the early 1970s by the Yakovlev Design Bureau for use aboard the Kiev-class aircraft carriers. Soon, two of the more widespread variants of this highly interesting aircraft will join the top ranks of the Soviet aviation tree in the next major update, War Thunder, New Power. Briefly, the first operational Soviet strike aircraft with VTOL capabilities, combining the abilities of both conventional fixed-wing aircraft and helicopters. It is the Yak-38M. It's a jet fighter for USSR of rank 6. My foot, it fell asleep. Oh my god, that feels weird. The pros are that it has VTOL capabilities, numerous payload options, and premium bonuses for the Yak-38. So the Yak-38M is going to be the standard tech tree version, while the Yak-38 will be the premium one. Cons, however, are that it is subsonic.
What the hell?
Here's some history on the unit, if you are interested. What a bad time for my foot to screw me. And here we've got some screenshots. So this is a very nice color of blue, mind you. I really like that color. I'm not so sure about the puke green down here, but at least the color of the rest of the aircraft looks really nice. Doesn't exactly look like the color that you can see in real pictures, but I think that's just because of the sunlight. In War Thunder, the Yak-38 and its later modification of the Soviet response to the Harrier jet, also arriving in the game as part of the upcoming New Power update, and covered in a previous dev blog. Unlike the Harrier, however, the Yak-38 incorporates even more unorthodox design choices and offers its future pilots a greater selection of secondary weapons, which when coupled with its VTOL capabilities make it a true force to be reckoned with on the battlefield. Among the most notable differences which distinguish the Soviet Yak-38M from the Harrier is the fact that the Yak-38M is powered by up to 3 engines, compared to the Harrier's 1. The main engine is a R28-300 turbofan engine generating 7,300 kgf of thrust and powering the aircraft's 2 rear thrust nozzles. Nozzles, like schnoz. The other 2 engines are a pair of RD-38 turbojet engines mounted vertically behind the cockpit and generating 3,250 kgf of thrust each. I'm just going to assume that that's a lot. The latter engines are used by the aircraft solely for VTOL maneuvering, whereas the other engine is used for both the VTOL as well as generating thrust for forward movement. Pilots can easily observe the engineering sympathy during VTOL maneuvers as large hatches open up on both the ventral and dorsal side of the aircraft, allowing air to flow through the 2 vertically mounted engines, while the rear thrust nozzles get pointed downward, enabling hovering. Overall, the Yak-38M can reach a top speed of around 1,150 kilometers an hour in normal flight, while also being able to get up to 450 kilometers an hour in hover mode. Having established that the Yak-38M is no slouch when it comes to its flight characteristics, it's also worth noting that the aircraft has access to a fairly powerful weapons arsenal too. The aircraft can be equipped with a range of unguided bombs and rockets. Additionally, gun pods as well as guided munitions in the shape of the infamous R-60AAM and KH-23M AGM. This allows it to tackle a wide range of combat missions from ground support to air combat patrol with relative ease. And then here you got some more screen shits, so you can see some what look like unguided rockets there on the aircraft. And then some, I'm assuming those are missiles. They look kind of scary. Rocket pods. I don't see their gun pods. And then it looks like a mix of rockets and missiles. I don't see the gun pods. It would have been nice to see those. Unless that was on the first image. That might be what. No, but those look like rockets. I don't know. I'm not for certain. While the Yak-38M will be available to all pilots as the new top aircraft of the Yak-11 line in the Soviet aviation... Oh my shit, they actually tell you what line it's going in. How often do they actually tell you that? The earlier Yak-38 modification will be exclusive to a special bundle available in our online store. Although the differences between the two aircraft are minimal, the Yak-38 was most notably offers its prospect... or its prospective owners additional rewards thanks to its premium status, as well as an instant access to the new VTOL mechanics for pilots particularly eager to try them out. Okay. It's neat that when they add this new type of aircraft, I've already praised Gaijin for the next update for doing that with the dreadnoughts and battleships, where every nation, except Italy, is getting something, and they're not even just getting like one or three, it's everyone's getting two things. At least two of the bigger ships that they're bringing to each tech tree. And they're doing that for these VTOL aircraft as well. They introduce new VTOL aircraft, and they're at least giving them to more than just one or two nations at a time. They're giving them to three nations, which, again, I think is a lot better than how they... well, than what their track record shows. So, yeah, exciting new addition. I think that the plane looks very beautiful, but it's no Harrier, that's for sure. I love the color on it, and I'd like to fly it someday. Of course, it's going to be a new $60 premium, probably $60 premium, on the bundle store, so if you're looking to grab that, make sure you save up a little bit of change for the next major update. And then you have to decide if you want the Yak-38 or you want the U.S. Harrier, since they'll both be bundle packs, or if you want the British Premium Harrier, which is a Golden Eagle premium. But if you haven't been paying attention to the news, there has been other stuff that has been announced. Of course, we have the other Harrier. Four new variants are coming, two for Great Britain and two for the United States, one premium for each. The Russians are also getting the MiG-21 Bis jet fighter. The Swedish are getting the SK-60B, which is like a trainer attacker slash aircraft thingy. And then for naval forces, they're splitting the tech trees, so there's going to be a coastal fleet and a blue water fleet. And along with that, they're adding dreadnought battleships to the game for the first time, starting with the earlier dreadnought ships, such as the HMS Dreadnought for British, and they're also getting the HMS Colossus. Germany's getting two ships, including the SMS Westphalen, which was shown off. The Japanese are getting the Setsu, as well as the Ikoma armored cruiser. The United States is getting the USS North Dakota battleship, as well as the USS New Orleans heavy cruiser. And then they also shown off the Maria for the Soviet Union, but they're also getting something else as well. They showed off three new AI aircraft carriers for high-tier jet battles, one for US, one for the Soviet Union, and one for Great Britain. All of them look really, really good and highly detailed with catapults and all that other inner working stuff. Ground Forces has seen a lot of new additions as well, including new top-tier main battle tanks for the Soviet Union, including the T-90A. And the Germans are getting the Leopard 2A6. The Russians are also getting a new Rank 6 Premium, a T-72 AV Terms, a Syrian version, which is really neat, but also really weird to see a Premium T-72. Germany is also getting a new top-tier SAM vehicle, the MAN truck, an 8-wheeled big fuck you vehicle. The British are getting the VFM-5, a unique sort of prototype-ish, experimental, I don't know, whatever it is, and a weird-looking light tank, so they're actually getting a light tank for high tier. France is getting the Lorraine 37L at rank 1 tank destroyer. They're also getting a new main battle tank, a second variant of their current main battle tank, though they haven't shown a dev blog on that. China is getting the PTZ-89, a domestically built Chinese tank destroyer. Italians are getting a new premium rank 2 or 3, I think, medium tank, the prototype M1643. And then the United States are so far getting their 8-wheeled tank destroyer slash support vehicle finally in the form of the M1128 Stryker MGS. Then of course Dagger engine is being upgraded to Dagger 6.0, which is bringing with it a new rendering for skies, lighting, clouds, and destruction, better looking effects and explosions and all that kind of stuff, and gunfire. Lots of new neat things there as well. And then of course they're also adding new hangars for air, ground, and sea, with moving vehicles and moving people and utility workers around the field, which is also really nice to see. Anyways, guys, that's going to bring this one to an end. I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video. Thanks for watching. Bye.